بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Continuing reading from الملخص الفقهي للشيخ صالح بن فوزان. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى reward him the best in this life and the hereafter. This chapter concerning باب في أحكام الآنية وثياب الكفار. Chapter concerning ruling concerning utensils. Utensils and the clothes of the non-Muslims. الآنية هي الأوعية التي يحفظ فيها الماء وغيره، سواء كانت من الحديد أو الخشب أو الجلود أو غير ذلك. Utensils, things which vessels which we utilize it for keeping and preserving the water. Doesn't matter what types of utensils we talking about, made of iron or wood or skin or anything. The originality والأصل فيها الإباحة. The originality is that is permissible. فيباح استعمال واتخاذ أي إناء، كل إناء طاهر ما عدا نوعين. Every vessel or utensils, cups, plates, trays, it is permissible to utilize it and to keep it as long as it is pure, with exception of two types. Number one, إناء الذهب والفضة. All utensils are permissible to utilize with exception of something that made out of gold or silver. Doesn't matter if made out of it or is painted with it or mixed with it. Unless it's something utilized for the fixing of it. ودليل التحريم إناء الذهب والفضة قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تشربوا في آنية الذهب والفضة. The evidence that this utensil that made out of gold or silver is forbidden, the statement of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, do not drink in utensils that made out of gold or silver. ولا تأكلوا في صحافهما, and do not eat in its plates. فإنها لهم في الدنيا ولنا في الآخرة. It is for the non-believers to enjoy in this life, and it's for us in the hereafter to enjoy it. وقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي يشرب في آنية الفضة إنما يجرجر في بطنه نار جهنم. A person who drinks in utensils that made out of silver is a person that dragging hot water into his fire in the hereafter. Agreed upon. والنهي عن الشيء يتناوله خاصا أو مجزأا فيحرم الإناء المطلي المموه بالذهب أو الفضة أو الذي فيه شيء من الذهب والفضة ما عدا الضبة اليسيرة من الفضة كما سبق بدليل حديث أنس رضي الله عنه أن قدح النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم انكسر فاتخذ مكان الشعب سلسلة من فضة رواه البخاري. When the Sharia forbid us of utilizing something, is that mean is forbidding us to utilize it as all or partial? As a result of this, it is forbidden to drink or to eat in utensils that made out of silver or gold, or that is painted with it, or anything that mixed with it, with exception that something that you do it for fixing, due to the fact that the cup of the Prophet ﷺ been broken, so the Prophet ﷺ utilized a chain of silver to fix it. قال الإمام النووي رحمه الله انعقد الإجماع على تحريم الأكل والشرب فيها وجميع أنواع الاستعمال في معنى الأكل والشرب بالإجماع. It is a concise opinion among the scholars according Imam النووي that forbidden to eat or to drink in silver or gold utensils or utilizing them in any methodology or means related or eating or drinking. And prohibition of utilizing them, it covers male and female. لعموم الأخبار وعدم المخصص. That because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made it general and he did not make it specific. Only exception that lawful for women to beautify themselves with gold and silver. As for the utensils that belong to the kuffar, وتباح آنية الكفار التي يستعملونها ما لم تعلم نجاستها. It is lawful to utilize cups, plates, spoons, forks that belong to the kuffar as long as not you don't know that impure or there is impurity in it. If we know that these utensils been utilized in something impure, all what you have to do is to wash it. Number two, جلود الميتة يحرم استعمالها. Skin of dead animals is forbidden to be utilized unless we tan it. فقد اختلف العلماء في جواز استعمالها بعد الدبغ. والصحيح الجواز وهو قول الجمهور لورود الأحاديث الصحيحة بجواز استعمالها بعد الدبغ. ولأن نجاسته طارئة فتزول بالدبغ كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يطهره الماء والقرض وقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم دباغ الأدين طهوره. As for the skin of animals, if the animals is dead, is not permissible to utilize the skin. But if it been tanned, that means been treated with water and salt and put in the sun, there is a special methodology to tan the skin, now became lawful to be utilized. Because the Prophet ﷺ had told us that any skin of animals that been tanned is became pure. So that means you can wear shoes out of the skin of animal or a coat or jacket. You can make a prayer rug out of it as long as they tan. Last point, تباح ثياب الكفار إذا لم تعلم نجاستها. Clothes of the non-Muslims is pure to utilize and to wear it without washing, as long as you don't know and you are not sure that is impure. That because the originality is the tahara, and you could not treat it with your doubt. He said, maybe they did this, maybe they did this. There is no maybe. Unless you're sure that impure, you could not utilize it. Now you can wash it and you can wear it or you can pray in it. And also it is permissible. وَيُبَاحُ مَنَا سَجُوهُ أَوْ سَبَغُوهُ. If they crochet something, the kuffar, if they crochet something, they tailor it or they dyed it, it's permissible to use it. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه كانوا يلبسون ما نسجه الكفار وسبغوه. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wear clothes that been made or dyed by the kuffar, and also the Sahaba did so, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى knows best. Any question, comments, concern, correction, feel free to do so. Make me say